encourages, guides us, and he is the backbone of all our department activities. Welcome you, sir. Next, I am delighted to welcome the self-finance program coordinator, controller of examination of our college, and my beloved professor, Dr. R. Palaniappan, sir. He motivates and supports us in all our department activities and encourages to do a lot of activities in our departments. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Now, I welcome the resource person of today's national webinar, our department faculty members, Mr. A. Maheshwari, madam. Welcome you, madam. Next, I welcome the faculty and student participants from in and around India who are here to enrich their knowledge through the national level webinar. Welcome you all. Next, I welcome all my department faculty members who stood by side in all our department activities. Finally, I welcome one and all. Thank you.
Leadership is unlocking people's potential to become better. I'm happily welcome our Controller of Examinations, Coordinator of Programs, Dr. R. Palaniappan, sir, Associate Professor in Computer Science. The man who set his visions high and encouraging all our accomplishments to give the felicitation. Sir, please.
Thank you, Prem. Very nice words given by Professor Prem of our college, who has been engaged in several activities. Respected principal of our esteemed institution, Dr. P. Sundarapandian, the head of the Department of Computer Application Self-Finance, Professor Rajkumar, the technical session speaker, Madam Maheshwari, and the person who is going to propose vote of thanks, NJS Parameswar. A very good evening to all of you and to the participants who are in this forum. Really happy to give the inaugural felicitation address in this national webinar on open shot video editor. Professor Rajkumar has expressed that his department has been doing larger amount of wonders. I'm happy to express in this forum, this department has given lot of students to our IT industry. And currently, many of their students are doing internships in reputed concerns in and around Virudhunagar. One feather to their crown, one of their student is getting ₹25,000 per month as incentive in a company, in an IT company in Virudhunagar. Such a wonderful department organizing several activities for the important stakeholders of such as students. They have conducted several faculty development programs for the welfare of faculties in information technology and other field also. They have made a lot of activities. He has only told a tip of an iceberg. I am very happy with their department, their activities. They are running the department successfully with nearly, I could say that 100% of their department students get placed everywhere. Those to leave out students getting going to higher studies. So in this regard, I am happy to appreciate the Department of Computer Applications, and they have taken a very good topic on open shot video editor. Appreciate Maheshwari madam for taking this task of elaborating the public on open shot video editor. Why video is now becoming popular? The video effects are now really appreciated by people in terms of animation, in terms of creativity, in terms of innovations that they want to push into the field of, even into the field of business and corporate sectors. When we become masters of this video editing, when we become masters of VFX and other things, really we are going to get very good positions in IT companies, not only in IT companies, but also in corporate sectors for marketing their products. In this regard, I appreciate it's houseful, 250 participants, and many are in the pipeline. And we have given more exposure on information technology. This area of open shot video editing will be helpful to you. And our faculty members are doing a wonderful task in dissipating knowledge to the public and to the students as a whole. I wish this national webinar on OpenShot Video Editor fullest success, and I wish the participants all success in their endeavors. I thank once again the organizers of this event for to have given me a chance to inaugurate this function. Thank you. Wish you all success. Best wishes.
Time to start the technical session. Before then, I introduce the resources of the webinar. Today we have a wonderful resource. She was Mrs. Seema Shree. And having a 1 year of experience in the great in block learning and 1 year of experience in all technique college and serious in case. She has completed MCA, PGDCA, and PGDAO. Set and net examination. Handled reports made faculty for various institutions. Specializing image browsing, artificial intelligence, data mining. Recently, she was conducted a research. She was acted as a resource person in the oriented course. She completed nearly six NPTEL application courses in the artificial intelligence domain, and a few of them completed at the late. She was acted as a coordinator in various seminars in the campus. So she also presented a paper in international level conferences. Three international papers and acted as a resource person in nearly 20 10 of them in national level, 10 of them in state level. So I'm happily invite Mr. Gimari to have a session. Please.
Thank you, Prem Sakar sir, for a nice introduction, giving the brief introduction about me. And thank you, Palnepan sir, for giving wonderful blessings towards to the seminar. Thank you, sir. So thank Almighty God to happily to coordinate this national level webinar on OpenShot Video Editor. And thank you our management and principal sir, and controller of examination, our SF coordinator sir, and our head of the department to give the opportunity to handle the session. Thank you, sir. The OpenShot Video Editor. So it's an open source software, and it is available on Linux, Mac, and Windows operating systems. It is an open source and free software, and anyone can download it and distribute it and modify it and upload it based on the GNU license validations. So for what purpose we can use the OpenShot Video Editor? We can create amazing videos and films, animations with a simple interface, and it provides a rich feature set to create such animations. So any software having its own feature set, right? The OpenShot Video Editor has a different and many, it supports many kind of features. The first thing is cross-platform. The video editor software can be supported in Linux and OS X and Windows operating systems. And the second point is, the second characteristics is trim and slice. Using this feature set, we can do quickly trim our videos and find those perfect moments. That is, we can cache the perfect videos in our project. And the third feature set is animation and keyframes. Using this powerful animation framework, We do lot of animations effects such as fade, slide, bounce, and animate any element in our project files. The fourth kind is unlimited tracks. So as an open source software, the video editor software supports many tracks to be added to Blender audios and effects in our original videos. We can adding several tracks by using watermarks, and we can also some background videos to our project files and video effects. Using video effects engine, we can remove the background from our video and invert the colors and adjust the brightness to our original video. The 3D animation. We blended beautiful 3D animated titles and effects to our project file, such as snow and lens effect and flowers and flying text. We can also add that slow motion and time effects by using this feature set. And the simplest one is the OpenShot video editor has the simple user interface. And it provides easy to use interface for video editing. We can use this software. The open source is available online. So it is a free software. We can download it and redistribute it or modify it under the terms of GNU, General Public License by Free Software Foundations. So can I move on to the demo session? That is the hands-on session, how we can work with OpenShot video editor. So before getting into it, first we can see about how we can download the OpenShot video editor. So open Google. So search for OpenShot video editor. So you can notice that the first link provides the original source where we can download the OpenShot video editor software. That is www.openshot.org. So when you open the image, that is the page, so click the download button. And you can see that the browser asks whether it is for 64-bit installer or 32-bit installer. So before that, you can download the software. You have to check your system premises. That is going to my computer. And I click on it. And you can see the properties. So here you can see what is your system architecture, what is your system OS supports. It is a 64-bit operating system. Once you can verify it, you can click directly this download button. If your system is having 32-bit installer, then you can click the 32-bit link and download the corresponding software. So already I have installed this software in my machine. So directly I can open this software. So once completed your download, an OpenShot video will be installed in your system and it is available in your system in start menu, and you can do the editing operation. So when you are opening your OpenShot video editor window, the IDE will be opened. So as you all know, it consists of the menu bar. It contains the buttons to open, save, and export your video project. And it consists toolbar. And it consists the functional tabs. It also consists the toolbars. which is having the buttons to explore your operations in a fastest manner. And the IDE shows, the left side of your IDE shows the functional tabs like project files, transition, and effects. So in this project files, here you can store all of your audio files, video files, and image files. What are all the files you are included in your project that will be added in this section. So I will discuss how these files are to be added in this area. The right side of your IDE is the preview window. It shows your video playback. You can view your video when you are doing the editing operation. Then the window consists the timeline. It visualizes your video project and it also elaborates what are all the files. That is, here the files, the audio files, image files, and video files are named as clips. And the clips, how the clips has to be added in this tracks. And here also we can show that how these clips are transistor and make effect, and how it can be blended to create your finalized video editing. So the timeline shows several tracks. So you can see the tracks. The purpose of a track is your file. What are all the files you are included? It will be appeared in the project file tab. Once these files are to be added to these tracks, then only it can be viewed in a preview window. So the tracks are used to add your clips in your finalized video project. The OpenShot video editor, maximum it supports, you can as a feature set, we can say that it supports unlimited tracks, but your efficiency, your finest project is you have to utilize maximum 10 tracks. So I can add the files. So you can import. You can add the files, what are all to be included in your project. So just right click on it and click import files. Here you can add the corresponding video file. So I can add it, the VKHNSMC campus 2. So I am doing the basic concepts behind the video editing. So in this, I don't want to need the tracks. So I can click the particular track and then right click on it and do it in a remove track. So it's enough for single track to perform the video editing. Once you can add the audio to your video, then your need of additional tracks. So by clicking this button, you can add several tracks. The topmost track is referred as the topmost layer, and the bottommost layer referred as the bottom layer. If you are very much interested in Photoshop editing application, then it will be familiar with this layers and tracks. So the file which is to be included, imported, it will be added to the corresponding tracks. So here you can see that. Here you can see that is a timeline. It's a scale. The scale provides the how many seconds you can view your video editing, and by default it will be 15 seconds. So I can reduce it. I can reduce it into 5 seconds. Why? Because this means we can perform the most accurate editing. Can perform the accurate editing. So for that purpose, I can reduce this time seconds. And you know that it is a playhead. Once you can click the playhead, it will be refer the current position of your video. Have you seen the corresponding video is previewed in your preview window?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Fine, sir. So while you are playing your video, then you can make some corrections. That is, you don't want need to some particular portions. Then you are going to cut the particular portions or remove the particular portions of your original video so that I can stop in that positions. So I have to cut the part of my video. So that for that purpose, I have to click the eraser tool, which will be appeared in a timeline section. So click the eraser tool and place it before the playhead. So while you are clicking, the video will be segregated into two parts. So place the eraser tool option again it. Then only you can select which video will be, which portion has to be cut. So here I don't want to need this portion means simply I can select the particular portion and simply I can select click the remove clip option. Sorry. So while we are deleting or removing the particular portion, you have to concentrate. That is, it is the dangerous one for eraser tool. When you are removing the abstract position, you can click the eraser tool and the part will be divided. So while you are removing the particular portion, so first is select the clip and then right click on it and do it in a remove clip. Otherwise you will make a mistakes. It is the effect of eraser tool. So it is very simple one. While the expert is using the eraser tool as a simple one, the beginners find out that it will be some dangerous. So here in this portion, I have to see about in my department. This is the computer applications department and this is our library. So I have to extract my department, right? So I can find out the exact position. So here, from this point, I have to split out the clip so that I can click again the razor tool and do it. The same operation. So place again the razor tool over there. Then only you can so this is so if you are preferring that you can to view the particular pose, place the playhead over the video clip and then click the play button over in the preview window, then you can see that. It is a simple one. So now removing the particular part of the clip, I can set that one point is clicking the razor tool. Another one is guys, please note this. First of all, you can remove the particular part of the clip by using the razor tool. The second option is so in this part I have to remove this part from my video clip, means to adjust the start and end position over this. So place the head, place the pointer over the start of the clip and it will be changed with the two-headed arrow. So once I can do it, I can get the correct accurate editing. This is the second one. So normally I can do this in my video editing at the end of my video project. So I simply click on it at the right side end of the edge and then decreasing my arrows towards to the end of my video session, then it will be clipped. It is the second way. And the third simplest one is, so you can do the clips or you can get the clips from the original video itself. So I can do it in another way. So select the video and right click on it and click the split clip. Here also you can see the dialog window appears. Here also your video will be played and it shows the starting point of your video clip. So I can click the starting point and then play it. So I can get the introduction video. So that is our college campus. So till that, I have to get my part of my video clip. So once I can get the particular position, I have to click the end button and having the name as a name, I'm giving the name clip one and then click the create button. So the corresponding clip will be here. You can see that the corresponding clip will be appeared in the project file functional tab. So it is another one way. So here also you can ask some questions. Ma'am, from the video, we can only remove the video from the starting, from the beginning questions. No students. We can also remove the in between part. So just placing my position. So here also I can get, it is our one of our another one computer block. So I can extract this particular portion so that I can place my starting position. So I have to make a clip and then select end, and I can give it as a clip too. It is for your reference. I can create from my original audio files. I can create the in between part by doing this. So by removing the part of the clip, we can do it. So while you are clipping your original video, the video will be placed in the project file folder. Also, your clips also placed in your project file folder. So another option is we can discuss that we can use the razor tool. Another one is we can adjust the left and right side of your video content. This is referred as slicing your video. So I can tell it another one demonstration. Clip. I can also add another one clip. So when you are adding two or more clips into a single track, the editor software will automatically create the some transitions like that. So if you don't want need this transition, then you have to select this particular transition effect and right click on it and remove transitions. By selecting the particular transitions over the start of the clip, we can see several transitions in this functional tab. So I can select normal transition effect and place it over my video clip. So So here you can see the transition effect. It will be applied over your video. So in the case of the clip is very small. So you can see the drastic changes over your video. So here you can see lot of options. So based on your idea, and you can add the corresponding effect, corresponding transitions over your video. Similarly, you can add the transitions. So whenever you perform the video editing, you should add the transitions from the start of the clip. Then it will be very catching point over your viewers. Those who are the persons you are watching your video. In my sample example, the start of the video having some transition effect. So you can see the difference. This is the transition effect. Similarly, you can add the effects over your video clip. By adding your effect over the clip, then you can get the corresponding letter. It will be appeared on your video clip. So when you are playing again, you can see the difference. You can see the corresponding bars will be appeared in your video. Right? So the transition is created, the video transition, like we can do it in the PowerPoint transition effect, and the effect is applied over the video. It will add some embarrassing moments to your video. So here also I can add another one effect. So you can see the blur effect over the video, and it is one kind of adding effects to your original video. So here in this moment you can see the difference, what is the originality, and after adding effects, how we can get the some transitions over the audio. All right, so are you having any doubts on this?
Ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, you have explained very clearly, ma'am, but initially you have mentioned about different tracks. What is the use of different tracks, ma'am?
Ma'am, if our, while you are making our presentation as a video, then you have to add your soundtracks over the video, right? Or else you can play the video and you should show some images. That is, you can point out some particular places. Then you want to wish about to. You want to see the particular places to your see your students, right? Then you can add the corresponding image over your video. For that, adding your images, adding your soundtracks, then adding your sounds over the video, we have used the corresponding tracks.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
So how we can add the audio over the video bits? it will be discussed on tomorrow's session, sir. So I can give the brief overview about the IDE and how it is working and how we can export our video, right, sir? So what are all the matters I have discussed? The ma'am asked, that is adding the purpose of the tracks, several tracks into our project folder, and adding images to our project, or else adding another kind of one video that will be included in our project, then how we can perform that, it will be discussed and on tomorrow's session, sir. So another one, right? I can continue my session. So here also, I don't want need this transition. I don't want need this effect. So I already said that the slicing between the clips. So slicing between the clips, I can perform the razor tool. Another one is adjusting the start and end position of a clip. Another one is from the project files folder, I can make several clips. Similarly, we are merging several clips into our project file. You can place your pointer over the playhead and click slice all, then you can get several options. That is, keep both sides and keep left side and keep right side. So we are performing this. So I can get a slice and keep left side. So I can get the portion that will be appear on the left side. So here you can see the difference. You can click the playhead over the select all, slice all option. When I click on it.
Excuse me, ma'am. If it is possible to add voice recorder in video or images.
Yes, sir. It is possible to add video and images over our video. So here I can having some demonstrations. So before that, I can convey that. So place the playhead over your video clip and right click on it and perform the slice all and keep left side. The portion which will be appeared on the left side, it will be keep as it is, and the right side portion will be removed. Similarly, so you see the difference. Keep right side. So the left side portion will be removed. So this is the right side portion. So I can add another one. Here I can add another one track. So I can place the image over my video. So first it will be added into project files section. Then only you can include it in your tracks. So in this video, I have to another one image. So here you can see the difference. So I can add another one image over the video. Then the video will be played back and you can see the particular portion, which image you have added, it will be shown in your original video. And you can also do the similar effects over the image. And similarly, you can do this by adding some more audios to your project files. That will be discussed on tomorrow's sessions. So while you are performing these kind of slicing and giving a transition and effects over your video, then you can export your video by clicking this export video button in toolbar, and you can give the corresponding name, that is introduction session.
Is it possible to increase the low audio 4 times in this software?
Yes, sir. We can reduce the audio level and it will be discussed on tomorrow's session. Any more, sir? So what are the questions you have posted in the chat box? That is,
yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I have one question.
Sound and adding videos.
Ma'am, I have one question. How can we increase the
your original finalized project? That will be discussed on tomorrow's session, and it will be consisting the effects over your video, and it will be discussed deeply on tomorrow's sessions. Thank you, sir. Any more questions?
Maybe use this editor in our mobile device.
No, sir. That is a desktop on software.
Yes, ma'am. Participant, if you have any queries regarding audio and sound, all these queries will be addressed later on tomorrow. The URL will be provided in the chat box, so the openshot.org. You have to visit the site and click the download option. Before downloading, you have to verify that your machine having a 32-bit architecture or a 64-bit architecture. Then you can download the software. So thank you, participants. No duty is more urgent than that of returning thanks. Let me invite one of the executive member of our webinar, Mr. N.J. Parameswaran, Assistant Professor of Computer Applications, to propose the word of thanks of today's session. After the word of thanks, the feedback form of today's session will be posted in the chat box. The participants, don't forget to fill it. You have to make sure that they have to fill both the feedback forms of today's and tomorrow's session. Then only you can get eligible for certificates. Thank you. Sir, please, permission, sir.
Okay. Good day, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure in proposing the word of thanks. I thank our college management for granting us permission to conduct this webinar. I thank our college principal, Captain Dr. P. Sundarabandian, for supporting us in all our endeavors. Thank you, sir. I thank our coordinator, self-financing programs, Dr. R. Palaniappan, sir, for encouraging us and supporting us in all our endeavors. Thank you, sir. I thank our head of the department and our department staff members for their support to organize this webinar. Thank you all. I thank our resource person, Mrs. A. Marishwari, ma'am, for providing us knowledge on an open shot video editor. Thank you, ma'am. I thank all the participants, professors, students from our college and other colleges for participating in this webinar. Thank you. Thank you all.
So thank you, participants. If you have any queries regarding this, that will be discussed tomorrow very detailed. So thank you for spending the time with us. We all meet once again in the tomorrow session. Thank you. Thank you. Good night.